Welcome to Tactical Tuesday. I'm sure some of y'all are wondering what Tactical Tuesday is. Well, in answer to get some more videos out there for different stuff like Pike and Shotte and Hail Caesar, and hopefully soon maybe Black Powder, maybe. I've come out with Tactical Tuesday, which is pretty much a video that I come out with every Tuesday, ironically. That deals with some stuff with Pike and Shotte, Hail Caesar, like some little tips, conversation, and just little things like that. So it's for all of our benefit, you know, for getting more tad bits of information. And if y'all, I have lots of videos that I'm planning to do to deal with different subjects, and if y'all have any videos that maybe y'all want me to talk about, do let me know in the comments below. So anyway, on today with Tactical Tuesday, I've decided to talk a little bit about Pike and Shotte, my favorite war game right here. If any of you that are watching this video that are new to wargaming or something, or you might have been interested in Pike and Shotte, go for it. I would definitely say, you know, here's the rule book, really nice, hardback, you know, they got wealth of information in here. It's really good, you know. The one thing I like about the mechanics with Warlord games is it doesn't primarily focus on the individual soldier itself. Rather, it focuses on the entire picture of the army, you know? Like, for instance, it's not like Warhammer Fantasy, where one model has a certain amount of attacks. Rather, an entire unit has a certain amount of attacks. So it's definitely a good game, worth your interest, and it does have quite a few army lists from 3 Years War to English Civil War, Italian Wars, and even the some Irish Wars in there. And they got a whole bunch of stuff, cannons. I mean, you can't go wrong with that. But anyway, so today, I have decided to talk a little bit about command and movement. A couple of things that I have been thinking about a lot lately. As I'm planning to go more deeper into Pike and Shotte with building up a more competitive army of royalists for King Charles, I've been thinking about, you know, what type of army do I really want to settle for? What type of command do I want and stuff? I have really only played really 2 games of Pike and Shotte. One of them was full-fledged with my good friend Trey, and another one was that skirmish, and it was that sort of skirmish, that I had posted on the, internet, with the dude Elliot. He kind of drifted off. He didn't have that much heart of a war gamer, but anyway. So, I began thinking about, command and mechanics and stuff, and especially when it comes to movement, like, what is required in the game for you to have a really good start off? And let me reword that. In the Pike and Shotte and in the Warlord games game mechanics, there are different features of which you have to which will be the crux of you achieving victory. And one of those, I have come to believe, especially when reading the Black Powder rulebook, yes, I did get that, and I will put a review on that pretty soon, is really movement. Movement is very important in this game. Now, of course, it is in every game, but definitely more so in Pike and Shotte. Now, for those of you who don't know what movement, how you command your troops, is that it's not a simple command phase where you just say, it's not a movement phase where you just move your guys wherever you want. You have to test against your leadership to make sure that your troops obey their obey your examples. To do this, you take a 2d6, you roll it. If you have a leadership of 8, within the number 8, you either need to roll equal to or below your leadership for you to achieve the order. Now, if you roll equal to or 1 below your leadership, you get 1 movement. So, infantry, for instance, can move 6 inches. If you roll 2 below your leadership, you get 2 moves. So then, your infantry can go 12 inches. If you roll 3 below your leadership and on down, you get 3 movements, which is 18 inches. So your troops can move very fast, very quickly across the battlefield, and this is really a key point in you achieving victory, from what I have seen. Now, I do know quite a few people who are often like, oh, well, I don't like dice games because you have to rely on chance and all that stuff, you know. You know, I don't like leaving my fate up to the dice, you know. I'm like, well, you see, with Pike and Shotte in these games, really, I would say 50% of it is chance. It is the dice rolling. Or, well, providence. It is providence, you know, to see whether you are, you know, what type of rolls you get. But also, it's your tactics. It's your planning that does get you places. For instance, I mean, you can have a unit. Well, there was a good instance where I had some musketeers. I was playtesting against myself, some different tactics and stuff, and I had a group of lifeguard musketeers behind a fence. And the cavalry and a unit cavalry came up and charged against them. The musketeers successfully made closing fire, caused one casualty. The cavalry charged in and made a lot of hits. Now, for those of you who know musketeers and Pike and Shotte, they have a 5 plus morale save, which is not good at all, and only 3 stamina. And so I was like, okay, they're going to die. However, I placed them behind cover, so that gave them a bonus. Yeah, that gave them a cover bonus for their morale, so it was now a 4 plus, and also they had a rear support. The cavalry did not have a rear support. The cavalry did make successful hits against them. The musketeers were able to save those with the fence to help them out, and also the rear support in the combat resolution phase of the combat gave them the edge, and it was a draw. So that's a good example right there that really what matters is how you plan and how well you support your troops, and how it's your tactics that really wins the game. The other 50% is your tactics and your movement. Now some of you might say,
how can I move my infantry? You know, I'm supposed to command the battlefield. How can I get my infantry to move, you know, so fast when it's up to the dice?
Well, quite simple. Fortunately, Pike and Shotte allows you to be very flex. It allows you to be able to have better control of your troops. This is why formations is another very vital part, I believe, in this game. If I can find... Yeah, command modifiers table. If you want your troops to be in a better position to obey your orders in a battle, then you better put them up in column formation. Column formation gives you a +1 to your command roll. Meaning, let's say you're a general at a command rating of 8. If you're given the order to the troops that are in march column, or limbered artillery, or cavalry that are in march column, you get a +1 to your command, which means that you have a 9. So that means you have much more of a chance. You have a better chance of getting some good movement off of that unit because they're in a formation where it allows you to have better control over it. Excuse me, I've got a hiccups. And here's what gets really good. That's off road. Another modifier is unit receiving the order is in march column. Oh well, excuse me. If the unit in march column is on a road, so like a little country road, or you know, if it's limbered artillery, cavalry march column, or infantry, and they're on a road, they get +2. That's a +2 leadership, which means that if you have a leadership of 8, yes, my timer's about to go off. That's my timer thing. If you have a leadership of 8, and you get a 2 plus command because your infantry, and well, because your units are in march column and they're on the road, you can have a leadership of 10. So you have much more of a chance of getting your guys to move quickly into combat. So all in all, when you're beginning the game, depending on what type of... Whenever you play Pike and Shotte, I would suggest a good size table, maybe a 4x8 would probably be a pretty good size. And it depends, like, if you're going to play long ways or, you know, sideways, whichever ways. Diagonally, or whatever. What I would suggest is putting your infantry in good positions where you can command them a lot better so that they can move quickly across the battlefield and get to key positions, like whether it's a fence position, it's an objective, or whatever. Really, you want to command the battlefield. If you can get your troops in the right positions and you can command the battlefield, you can defeat your enemy. And in closing, I say, well, what do you mean by command the battlefield? You know, well, by commanding the battlefield, I mean that if you can get to the middle of the table a lot quicker than your opponent, you have to force him, especially whenever he takes break tests and he has to fall back, to force him to give a lot more ground than what you're giving. You know, it's pretty, you know, say, you know, you got your table here, you know, your opponent's right here, you're right here, and you're able to get right here, you are commanding the battlefield. Because if you're able to beat your opponent, he'll be pretty much retreating off the table. And that's especially useful when it's cavalry. Because if cavalry are shaken and they go off the table, they're never coming back. So, yeah. So in closing, make sure that your troops are in the right formations for you to command them easier so that they have better movement and a better chance of moving. So anyway, this, gentlemen, is Tactical Tuesday. I thank you for watching the show. I will be coming out with different videos every Tuesday to go with this series. If y'all have anything that y'all want me to talk about, please let me know. I'll be doing my own videos, but if y'all have anything, do let me know. And I'm getting more serious on painting the rest of my Pike and Shotte army. I will be posting it on the internet pretty soon. And I am looking for guys to play against. If any of y'all are watching this and are anywhere near Sparta, North Carolina, let me know. I'm looking for someone to play Pike and Shotte with desperately. I mean, my good friend Trey, you know, he likes it, but he's not that much into it. And he's all the way in Georgia. So, yeah. But I'm looking for someone that's close by, to have some fun, competitive feelings, and you know, play and anything. But, yeah. So anyway, guys, take care. Cheerio.